Hi, I'm Kevin Castaneda, and this is Kev's Mindset. We talk everything finance, investing, mindset, and productivity. And today we're going to be talking about financial companies, more specific, the fintech companies like Affirm, SoFi, and much more. We're going to be talking about these companies and why they've been selling off so much. We're also going to be talking a little bit about the legacy kind of payment providers and why they're also falling. And we're going to be talking about this whole fintech space and the payment providers and all this and why we're going down, what's going on, why we're crashing down, and it looks like it's never gonna end. So we're gonna be going over that all that in this video. Before we do start though, go ahead and smash the like button if you do enjoy, and go ahead and subscribe if you do want to watch more of my content in the future. Now let's head straight into this video. Okay, so we've seen things like PayPal drop 40% from all-time highs. Now PayPal is a very established company nowadays. They grow year over year. We see a lot of growth every quarter. We see pretty consistent numbers from them, and we see pretty decent growth rates. So now we're seeing them come down a lot, and it's kind of like, oof, it's kind of a hit to the market. It's like, what's going on? We also see Visa falling down. We see Affirm down like 35% from all-time highs. We see SoFi down to about $18 again. We see Square down. We see all these companies down. And we're looking around the market, and we're like, okay, what's going on? This is simply my opinion of what's going on. In my opinion, I think we kind of overheated the market really fast. We had a quick rally going into the end of the year. We were kind of just in the midst of a dip. We rallied back up in the big caps, and the big caps sat kind of flat. Then out of nowhere, the big caps started pushing up, and then the fintech space pushed up with it. And we kind of got to this point now where we were very overheated. We had Affirm go to 170. We had SoFi in the like almost mid 20s. We had PayPal going to the sky. And the only thing that caused PayPal to start falling down was their potential acquisition of Pinterest, which never even happened. And they took forever to deny. And then once they finally denied it, still continued to push their stock down, which didn't really make sense. But that was kind of the start of it. We saw PayPal start dipping down. Then as PayPal started coming down, the other ones were heating up. But then it kind of reached a point where they all just started reaching an equilibrium and coming down together. So now we're looking at all these payment providers. And is this an opportunity for us, or is this the market telling us, hey, it overheated too much, these companies aren't worth this, and it was just a short-term rally? My opinion is that no, these companies are worth these. Maybe not their all-time highs right now, right away, in a second, but I think that these companies do have a lot of potential. My favorite is Affirm. I think PayPal is interesting, but I don't personally own it. I think that Affirm has the most upside when you look at it. If it hit 170, I think we can see Affirm. We could see a lot of upside with it. I think it's economic mode when we look at something like Affirm. You have to talk about their relationships with companies. The fact that they have a deal with Target. The fact that they have a deal with Walmart. The fact that they have a deal with Amazon. These are huge companies, huge corporations that have a lot of sales funnel through them. So if you're a company on the other side taking little bits from the loans that you give to their customers in order for them to buy a product that they really want, you're creating opportunity for their customer to buy something now and pay later, which is obviously your service. And then for that, the company like Amazon or Walmart or Target is willing to pay you as a form of like acquiring a customer. So it's kind of a customer acquisition cost that they're kind of taking out, and I'm assuming that's how they'll put it on their balance sheets. But looking at this from the company Affirm, you're like, wow, this is a great deal. So you as a firm, it makes a lot of sense to buy these dips. In my opinion, I think holiday season is gonna be incredible. A lot of people have a decent amount of money now after all the stimulus checks and wages being increased, and sure, inflation's higher, but we have had a lot of things to build wealth over these past year and a half. Not everyone, of course, but a lot of people have been able to do so and build more wealth over this past year and these past two years coming out of the pandemic. So we've seen a lot of that. So now we look at the market and we're like, okay, do we think that this end of the year, we have holidays coming, we have Thanksgiving, we have Christmas, we have Black Friday, we have all these things going on for us, New Year's coming up. Do we think that this holiday season is going to be as big as it usually is, or is it going to be even bigger? Are people going to try and buy more things that they can afford by using buy now, pay later? Now that's a huge option and something that's being adopted by many people. In my opinion, yes, I think a lot of people are going to look at buy now, pay later. They're going to look at, oh, I want to get this gift for this person and all these things. And then they're like, oh, I could just use buy now, pay later for these like bigger purchases. And I think that's what's going to happen. I think we're going to get a huge a huge spree in buy now, pay later over the holidays as people try to buy bigger gifts. People kind of push the limits a little bit. They think that this is a great option, which I mean, for some people it is. And as they use this, I think that the earnings for a firm and all these buy now, pay later companies and fintechs and all these transactions going through, I think they're going to do great in these next few months. So I think the market kind of overreacted. A lot of people were down from the all-time highs potentially in something like PayPal or Visa or Square or SoFi or Affirm, and maybe the people want to take profits, or maybe people wanted to sell at the end of the year to cover to take losses so that they could kind of do the wash sale method and buy back in 30 days. We don't know what it is, but the market did overreact really quick in one specific sector, which was the kind of fintech buy now pay later type of space. So I'm looking at this as a buying opportunity. I've added about 50% more towards my position on a firm. I've been looking at PayPal. I'm very interested. I might actually end up starting a position there. I'm not 100% sure though, because I do want to keep some cash on the sidelines in case my core positions do start coming down due to whatever downside catalyst comes around. So that's what I'm doing in the market. That's what I think about this space and this crash and this dip that's been happening. That's what I'm doing. Let me know what you think, what you're doing, and let me know in the comment section down below. I'd love to hear it. Go ahead and smash the like button if you did enjoy this video, and subscribe if you are new. See you in the next one.